the punch bowl the day after the party. And not a chicken to be found. I think they're all hungover. Too much watermelon. I can't wake up. Oh, it's adorable. Hey, there's the other one. Boy, they ate that thing, didn't they? Paper thin watermelon rinds. They had a good old time. That's money well spent. Oops. Ah, the only one not hungover. Hi, Iowa. Say hi. Oh, here we go. This is how it is every morning. Yep. They come a running. It's breakfast time. Hey, can I film a video before I feed you? Hi. Hey, peck my camera. Hey, good morning. Yeah, it's about time to feed you, isn't it? It smells like a skunk out here. That ain't good. I know it's not a skunk, it's some kind of weed, and I don't know what it is. Something out here smells like a skunk, and every time I walk through here or mow it, I smell skunk. Don't know what it is. Someday I'm gonna find it and I'm gonna eradicate that thing. Ugh, just nasty. Oh, hi. What am I looking at, Rascal? He doesn't know, he has no idea. But I wanted to show you something because I did an episode on invasive species and there was one thing that I didn't show you. Actually, there's a couple things I didn't show you and I'm gonna show you today because some people have been asking, actually more than some, a few people have been asking about it and I thought, ah, what the heck, I might as well do an episode on it. First thing I wanna show you is this. Right around the chicken coop, I don't mow my grass. I like to leave it long because grasshoppers love to hide in tall grass. So although I do mow my yard in order to gather up the grass and to keep it looking nice, I leave the area around certain areas overgrown. I keep it wild because I want to have a balance here. So the grasshoppers love to hide out here. Since they can't hide out in the yard, they all migrate over towards the chicken coop and they hide out in the grass. Well, every now and then, a grasshopper hops the wrong way. And that's why the chickens like to be outside so much as they wait around the perimeter. And then when the grasshopper hops in, bang, they get it. So it does, you know, there's a little bit of method to my madness over here. So they like to be out here. And when I walk around the chicken coop, they patrol the area because they get the grasshoppers to go in there. But right here is something that I noticed a week or so ago. And I had no idea these things were even here. Take a look at what's growing wild. This is wild. I didn't plant these and I've noticed them. Ever since I noticed this, I've seen them all over my property because once you see something, it kind of sticks in your head and you notice it somewhere else. And this is what I noticed. Little lanterns. Yeah, and they're all over this thing. It's loaded with them. This thing's growing totally wild, unplanted, unplanned, and unfertilized right here in the middle of the weeds. I'm glad I didn't mow these down. Otherwise, I would have missed out on something really amazing. Now, I don't know exactly what these are. Take a look at the leaf structure. Maybe you can tell me. There's a few different things that can look like this. First of all, tomatillos, but these aren't tomatillos. And there's also Chinese lanterns. And there's also ground cherries or something like that. I don't know, there's a few different things that come in a lantern. And what this is it will grow this weird, can you please give me a minute, okay? I'll feed you in a minute. They're demanding, they're just like kids. Notice me. Oh, but anyway, look at this. It's a lantern and you open it up. Ta-da, there's a prize inside. That's what I call it. But the berry gets bigger and bigger until finally it sometimes just rips out of the lantern. And this kind of protects it while it's growing, so I guess critters don't eat it. And I've bought Chinese lantern decorations before at a crafts fair where a lady actually grew them and saved the sticks, and they were real Chinese lanterns that naturally turn red. Some of these actually turn red in the fall and they're beautiful. But look. Actually, no, I'm sorry. They turned tan and she painted them red. That's what it was. That's why I bought them. I thought they were kind of cool. But look, I don't know what these are. So if you know what they are, let me know. I'm going to gather seeds from this when they get ripe. And I'm going to grow this inside because I've grown something similar to this and I loved how it grew. It looks like a pepper plant, nice and sturdy. And it has so many of these fruits on it. And if this thing can grow this well outside, being uncared for, can you imagine what it'll do in the voodoo garden? Yeah, crazy. Yeah. I love my stump. I love this stump. This is my bird waterer. I know, it's really cheesy. Oh, hey. You know, if you put a bowl of water down and you pick it up every couple of days, you'll find crickets. Oh, son of a gun. I'll have to keep that in mind when I'm feeding the birds. This is my stump. And at the very beginning of the season, I had this big honking tree here and I cut it down. But I planted these Jerusalem artichokes or sunchokes here. And I wanted to grow them around here because I thought, you know what, if they go wild, this would be a nice area for them to just spread out. And I'm growing these things, and but it's hard to keep them weeded because, you know, you got to be careful not to pull anything out that's growing right next to it. You might yank out the plant. So I kind of let it go, and I got all kinds of weird stuff, like a tuft of grass here and a weed over there. All right, let's see if I can hold the camera with one hand and hold the plant with the other. Look, little berries. Beautiful too, yeah. Little clusters of berries. And I know it's not deadly nightshade because deadly nightshade has totally different flowers, but with the leaf structure and the flowers and the berry, I believe that this is huckleberry. Yeah, huckleberry or garden huckleberry, one of the two. But either way, from what I understand, the berries are edible, but you gotta make sure that they're ripe when you eat them, and you gotta make sure, because this is a nightshade, you gotta be careful. Your animals or you don't eat the leaves because they're poisonous. But also, it's very closely related to deadly nightshade. And anything that I'm not 100% willing to bet my life on, I'm not shoving in my mouth. Not gonna do it, folks. I don't care what anybody says, but it is a really nice berry, and I've grown this indoors before with great success. So, you know, I'm gonna gather these berries, and there's a few seeds in each one of them. I'm gonna gather these and I'm gonna grow them indoors. So I figure, why not? But I wanted to also show you this, not just because I thought it was a cool plant, but what's going on with this cool plant. Right at the tip, it looks like, oh no, it's got some kind of disease going on. No, actually it doesn't. Oh, here they come. See? I better move my hand. Ah, those are clusters of black ants. Yes, on the tips of each one of these things, there's a, what they do is they take the leaves and they pull them together and hold them together with a mass of ants, and that's where the ants live. They're not destroying the plant. You know, they're not putting aphids on it. You know, some ants will put aphids on a plant and they'll farm the aphids. And these are not farming aphids. What they're doing is they're just living up here. They don't have an ant colony in the ground. Their ant colony is at the tip of the plant. That is amazing. I discover so much new stuff, and I never knew ants could actually live on the tops of plants. I thought that, you know, they come up there to eat and dance around in the sunshine, but who knew they actually lived here? Hey, while we're here, look. Looks like a dandelion, isn't it? Nope. This is not a dandelion. I don't know what this thing is, but I call it a dandelion with an attitude because these are all over the place. It has these weird looking, of course, dandelion looking flowers, but the leaves have these little thorns on them, almost like fuzz. So yeah, that's why I call them dandelion with an attitude. They're very closely related to the dandelion, I believe. Hey, you can't eat that. No, you can't. But I was gonna film a scene over here, and I came over here, and he's just chowing down a little piglet. But he loves compost. And the reason that he likes this compost, this as opposed to that pile, is this smells like manure. Yeah, I wasn't going to mention it, but I thought, ah, what the heck, I'm over here anyway, and I just caught him eating the compost. He cannot eat the compost because what happens is if you let compost break down and you don't turn it, it gets this really horrible funk. Those of you that have had it, you know what I'm talking about. It smells, there he goes again. Hey, no, don't do that. It smells like cow manure. That's exactly what it smells like, is cow manure, and guess what? That's exactly what it is. Yes, you're making cow manure if you don't turn your compost. Because what happens is, like, this is grass compost. You let it sit there and it gets all matted down, and you lift it up and it's all gooey and sticky, and yeah, you know what I'm talking about. Well, when a cow eats grass, or any kind of animal eats grass, in its stomach it has certain bacteria, and it turns it into manure, and then of course it comes out the opposite end, plop, and it's on the field. And you know what cow manure smells like, those of you that have cows. Well, that's exactly what's happening here. You got anaerobic bacteria that is acting on this stuff, and people hear the word anaerobic bacteria, it'll make you sick, blah, 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 and no. It can make you sick if you're not careful with it. The trick is to be smart about this. Now, this makes anaerobic bacteria because I haven't turned it, and that's what attracts him, because he wants to eat poop. That's what dogs do. Dogs eat poop. And so he's digging in here looking for the stinkiest part of the compost. What that does is, in his system, is that bacteria helps break down other things in his system, and that's why he gets the runs. So that's the whole thing that's going on TV now. Probiotics, you know, eat this yogurt with probiotics. All that is bacteria that's going into your system and breaking down the food, and of course you poop it out. It's helping you, you know, digest stuff. Well, your system generally has enough bacteria in it to work, so that's kind of like a selling scam for me, as far as I'm concerned. But that's what's going on here. The anaerobic bacteria is in there. All you have to do is treat it like any other kind of cow poop. You mix it all up, get some air in there, and the anaerobic bacteria goes dormant or dies, and the aerobic, the good bacteria that doesn't stink quite so bad, it will take over and break it down some more. So anyway, that's what I wanted to explain, why he's doing that. It's kind of a rudimentary explanation as to compost as I see it. But anyway, that wasn't the whole point of this. So Rascal kind of got me going. Right over there, I just noticed this. The weird things are going on, and I'm trying to keep everything together here. He's keeping things together over there barking, but I'm turning my compost and having a good day, and I'm looking out and enjoying the birds and everything, and I look down here. Look, this is just nuts. Right over here, careful, watch your step. This is one steep slope. Right here, all of this. Hey, the weeds are taller than you. Yep. But right here, look. Hey, come on, hold still. Pardon the wind in my microphone. It's a very windy day here in Iowa. Yep, it's what it looks like, folks. This is pot. This is marijuana, ganja, hemp. Yep, the old green stuff. And there is a crap load of it. I had no idea this was growing here. I mean, come on, you can look at something for so long and you don't even realize it's there because it wasn't very tall and it just all of a sudden grew. And you know what I'm wondering is if this wasn't fed by the runoff, because let me swoop down here. There you are. It's right downhill from my compost pile. So whenever the runoff comes down, it was probably feeding the pot. And my first episode that I did about this pot situation that I got going on here, I was sitting up here and I showed you the little plantation that was growing right here. Yep. They're still growing because, you know, like everybody knows, once you have this stuff, you can't get rid of it. It's kind of like kids. And, oh, there's one right there. Yep. It's everywhere, folks. But the thing is that I spoke to the police, and I had him out here because I wanted to make sure that I was totally kosher and everything was cool. I showed him the plants. I showed him that big one over there. And he said, ah, that's ditchweed. Nobody worries about that because in Iowa, it grows everywhere. And those of you that posted on the comment section, you know that hemp. By the way, I want to clear something up. Hemp and pot and cannabis, no matter what you call it, it's all the same thing. But it's all in different classifications, but it's all the same thing. It is all illegal in this country. Well, maybe not in Colorado, but you know, in Iowa. It is all the same thing. Whether it has THC in it, whether it doesn't have THC in it, whether you're growing it for the fiber, whether you're growing it for the drugs, hemp is pot. Hemp is the fiber that you get from pot, okay? Don't fool yourself into thinking that certain kinds are legal and certain kinds are illegal. No, it's all the same thing. No matter what anybody tells you, if it's a marijuana plant that's got those leaves, it is illegal for me to grow this on my property. It's not illegal for it to grow wild, apparently, by the police, because they say nobody can stop it. It's just like a dandelion. It was introduced here and now grows wild, so they don't hold anybody accountable for it. But you're not supposed to cultivate it. You know, you can mow it, you can admire it, you can look at it, but don't harvest it. I mean, like for smoking or anything like that, you can pull them up and burn them, he said. Pull them up, burn them, mow them, do whatever you want with it, but you know, just don't use it for anything. So I'm just letting it grow. I just want to let you guys know, but anyway, keep up. I gotta show you something. That was nothing over there. This is the mother load over here. Yep, this is tick country. Ooh, grasshopper country too. Wait till you guys get bigger. I'll be catching you for my chickens. Grow now. You will be dinner later. Okay, watch your step. There's all kinds of like holes and sticks, and there's even some farm machinery in here. Whoever had this, just really just let it go. But right next to this old building over here. Barbed wire fencing. Oh yeah, that'll be fun to step on. But no, look right here. Yeah, I didn't look over here. I mean, why would I? This, it's like 10 feet tall. This, it's nuts. Who could have known? Well, I should have known. I mean, come on, look at how big this area is. Come on up close and hey, it smells good. It smells good in here. All I could do when I saw this after my jaw dropped was laugh. Oh, I laughed. Yep. Every single plant here. There's not one single thing that you're seeing that isn't pot. Nope. This is marijuana. The green stuff. And it just goes on and on. It's this huge area. But the size of these plants are what got me. You know, I thought that because there is a mulberry tree that blocks the view of this when you're standing regularly up there. I never saw this until I came around because there was no reason for me to, you know, get ticks all over my legs and endanger myself. But look. This is a good up close shot of this baby. Look at that. The stem is thicker than my thumb. I can see why they raised this for fiber, you know? And this is not, of course, nearly as big as I'm sure that they would grow it if they fertilized it. This thing's going to flower, it's got seeds. It is a big hunk of beauty. And you know, when you stand by this downwind from it, you get the smell, you know? Anybody that's ever been around marijuana, you know that smell. Yeah, it's blowing in the breeze. My own personal forest of triffids. Yep, they are everywhere, folks. I thought that I had this major find that one time when I saw those, and it kind of freaked me out a little bit because it's not something that you see in Minnesota, and so here I moved down to Iowa. Of course, I wasn't born yesterday. I've been around pot before, but the fact that I actually saw it on my property kind of, you know, wigged me out a little bit. But I'm calm now. I got myself together. I realize that it's not the end of the world. It's not going to get me arrested or anything because I'm not doing anything with this. This is just an old weeded back section of my property. And these plants are having a good time. They're not hurting anybody. I'm not hurting anybody. The police are fully aware of what's going on over here because you see this when you drive down the roads. Once you see this, you see it everywhere, you know, because once you get it in your eyesight, when I'm driving down these old dirt roads right alongside these farmers' fields, I'm seeing pot everywhere. You can't get rid of this stuff. It's here to stay. And you know what? It's actually a beauty to look at. So I'm okay with it. I'm not gonna freak out anymore. And possibly I'll just film these as they grow and update you on them just for the heck of it, you know, just for the heck of it. I could just imagine how one of these would grow with some compost tea and a little Praxis method pruning. Wouldn't that be insane? One of these days, if they make it legal to grow this here, one of these is probably going to find its way into my garden. But until then, it's going to remain in the wild section of my property, which is about maybe 3/4 of an acre back here. And it's perfectly okay if it grows back here. It's kind of a nice little backdrop, isn't it? Yeah, a little triffid forest. Okay, anyway, thank you everybody for joining me for this weird, strange things on my property episode. I really like doing these because it's fun to go out there and just, you know, adventure. Okay, that wasn't funny at all. That's thistle. Yep, that's a thistle. Pretty flowers, nice and purple, but oh boy, they hurt. So you got to be careful when you're like me and you talk like this because you could actually hurt yourself on stuff. Anyway, thank you for joining me. I really do appreciate it. I hope you're having a great day. I'm having a fantastic day, except I lost Rascal out here. And he gets lost out here and he'll stay out here for hours. And all you see is the weeds moving every now and then, but he loves it. This is what he does. He brings ticks home. I pull the ticks off of him. He's happy. I'm happy. He's keeping all the bad things away from me. I don't know what he's looking for. Right now he's looking for a bull snake up there. But anyway, I got to get going before something crawls up on me. I can just imagine there's ticks out here. Thanks for joining me. I really do appreciate it. Have a great day, everybody. Bye. Okay. Get me out of here. Ugh.